Hi guys! In our second question about Lewis structures, we're going to go through a series of questions that ask us to find the form of charges of a certain molecule, as well as, of course, you're going to have to know the Lewis structure for this molecule. So let's start by methoxide ion. This is an easy question to solve. It's pretty straightforward, as long as you have the periodic table with you, and you know exactly how to calculate the form of charges. So we're gonna have to write the form of charge equation first. So how do you guys find the form of charge? So I'm gonna put this here just as a reminder for you guys. So form of charge is equal to the total valence electrons of an atom. So let's say, for example, we have nitrogen. Nitrogen has 5 electrons in its valence shell. So then you would put 5. So total, so valence electrons electrons. Then you subtract from the valence electrons the number of lone electrons. So the electrons present in lone pairs. So number of lone electrons, and then you subtract from this number as well, you subtract half of the number of electrons present in bonds. So there's two ways, there's two ways to write this. You can either, what you could do is count the number of covalent bonds and write number of covalent bonds here. So number of covalent bonds made by this atom that you're calculating its form of charge. So I wouldn't say just count the number. I would say just count the number of bonds for the atom, and then you would know this number over here. So number of bonds. Just write number of bonds. Sometimes atoms might have double bonds or triple bonds as well. Now you could write it as minus number of bonds, or you could write it as minus half times number of electrons involved in bonding. So for example, if you have, I'll give you just an example. So let's say you have H2O. So valence electrons, let's say for O, is 6. We know that it's 6. Minus number of lone electrons. How many lone electrons does oxygen have? It has 1, 2, 3, 4. So that would be 4. Minus number of bonds. So that would be 1, 2. Or half of number of electrons involved in bonding. How many electrons are involved in bonding? 1, 2, 3, 4. Remember, each bond represents 2 electrons. So half times 4 is equal to 2. So it's up to you guys which one you feel comfortable with. You can go ahead and write it. So let's do our first example, methoxide ion. First, remember, we need to know the Lewis structure for this molecule. So again, we start by calculating the number of valence electrons in all the molecule. So C has 4. There's 3 hydrogens and each one has 1 valence electron, so that's 3 times 1 plus oxygen. If you look at the periodic table, it's 6 electrons. And then you have a negative charge. Remember, negative charge means you have an extra electron, so you add it over here. So now you'd have a total of, you have 7 over here, you have 13 plus 1, that's 14 valence electrons. So now what do we do? Remember, carbon is a central atom, and put the H's on the sides and the O over here. Connect them by bonds. Now we used up 8 of our 14 valence electrons. We still have 6, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. The reason is because after you, whatever leftover electrons you have, you're going to have to use it to fill up the octet, to satisfy the octet rule for the terminal atoms first, and then the central atom. So now let's check out everything. H has H has two electrons, it's satisfied. O has 8, satisfied, and carbon has 8. So everything's satisfied. Remember that you have to put a negative charge over here. So this is the Lewis structure, but we still haven't calculated the formal charge of each of the molecules. So how do we do that? So let's start by formal charge of the hydrogen. How many valence electrons does hydrogen have? It has 1. How many lone pairs it has? It has 0 lone pairs. Minus. How many bonds is it making? 1. So minus 1. So the final answer for hydrogen formal charge is 0. So now you know that this is 0. This is 0, and this is 0. Let's do the formal charge for carbon. Carbon has 4 valence electrons in its final shell. 4. How many lone pairs does carbon have? 0 lone pairs. Lone electrons, sorry. Minus oxygen, the bonds that you have, the carbon making. So 1, 2, 3, 4. So that's 4 bonds. So you have 4 minus 4, that is equal to 0. So carbon has a formal charge of 0. Finally, let's look at oxygen. Oxygen has 6 electrons in its valence shell. Minus. How many lone electrons does oxygen have? Let's see. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So it has 6 lone electrons. Minus. How many bonds is it making? Well, oxygen in this case is making 1 bond, so minus 1. So now you have 6 minus 6 minus 1. That is equal to minus 1. So then, the oxygen has a minus 1 formal charge. Now, we didn't talk about one thing. The fact that, first of all, the molecule has a negative charge, right? Well, it has to, the formal charges have to add up to negative 1. So if you have a negative, charge on a molecule, then the formal charges should add up to negative 1. So the formal charge of all the atoms inside the molecule should add up to negative 1. And over here we have 0 plus 0 plus minus 1, and there you go. So this is how we solve such problem. Let's go ahead and solve our next example. Oxonium ion, or CH2OH+. So in this molecule, we have the same components as this molecule, the methoxide ion. So let's go ahead and do the valence electrons for this molecule. So again, we have 4 for carbon, we have 2 times 1 for the 2 hydrogens, plus the 6 for the oxygen, plus the 1 for the hydrogen. Now this one has a positive charge, so we have to subtract 1 from the electrons. So now you have 6, 12, 13 minus 1, that's 12 electrons, valence electrons. Okay, let's go ahead and put the components. Okay, connect them. Now, we used up 8 electrons out of the 12, so we still have 4 left. So remember that you start off filling up the terminal, and then you go to the central. So in this case, the H's are satisfied already. What about the oxygen? Oxygen has 4 electrons, it needs 4 more. So 1, 2, 3, 4. So we used up all the electrons that we have. But the carbon, if you look at it, it has 6 valence electrons. It doesn't have 8 here. So it's not satisfied. So what do we do in this case? we use up one of the lone pairs of oxygen and put it over here. So now we have double bonds. So we have double bonds over here. And then of course, you do the bracket and you put the positive charge. So what about the formal charges? Let's calculate the formal charges. So the formal charge of hydrogen is zero. We already calculated it. It's pretty simple for hydrogen. If it's making one bond, then its formal charge is zero. Most likely, most of the cases, the H is going to have a formal charge of zero. Let's look at the formal charge of carbon. So in this case, carbon has four valence electrons minus no lone electrons, minus how many bonds? Four bonds. One, two, three, four. So that would be a formal charge of zero. What about the oxygen? So oxygen has six valence electrons minus. How many lone electrons does it have? It has two. And then you have how many bonds? Three bonds. So you have six valence electrons, you have two electrons, and then you have three bonds. So that would be 6 minus 5, and that would be plus 1. So oxygen has plus 1 charge. So this is how you do such a molecule. Now, there are some rules that you have to abide by when you're doing a formal charge. There's a rule that states that you need to have the least formal charge on a molecule. So if you have different options of spreading out the bonds, you need to choose the one that has the least formal charge. Number two, electronegative molecules, or atoms, they are not supposed to have a positive formal charge. The more electronegative you are, the more strongly you're going to hold electrons. You're not going to lose them easy. So all having a positive charge is something that is not preferable. So anyway, this is how the molecule like this would look like. Now, of course, in this case, we have a positive charge on the O. It's not likely, but in this situation, this is what the molecule looks like. Let's go ahead and do part C now. CH3NO2, or nitromethane. So again, the process is still the same. Valence electrons first. 4 for carbon. Then you have 3 hydrogens, so 3 times 1. Plus, nitrogen has 5 valence electrons, plus, oxygen has 6, and there's 2 oxygens, so 6 times 2. So you have 7, plus 5, that's 12, plus 12, that's 24 valence electrons. So, put the C here, N, then the O's, then the H's. Connect the atoms with a single bond. Okay, so now we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So 6 bonds. So 6 times 2, that's 12. 24 minus 12, that's 12 extra electrons that we have that we need to use to fill up the octet rule. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. So we have satisfied the O. What about the N? The N has 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 6 electrons. It needs 8. Carbon is satisfied. So let's move one of the lone pairs here. So we can have a double bond. This way, we can actually allow the N to be satisfied. So let's move it. Now, of course, you can move either a lone pair from this oxygen or from this oxygen. So it's up to you guys, whatever you want to choose. Now remember that we're going to talk about something called resonance later. And in resonance, we're gonna have to see that whether you take it from this bond or this bond, that's gonna give you a resonance structure. So don't worry about that for now. Let's see now the formal charges. So the carbon, 4 valence electrons minus 0 lone electrons minus 4 bonds, that would give you 0. Formal charge of, let's start with this O first. Let's call it 1. This is 2. So Fc1, O1. 6 valence electrons minus 6 lone electrons minus 1 bond, that would be minus 1 formal charge. So that has a minus 1 formal charge. What about FCO2? This one. You have 6 valence electrons minus 4 lone electrons minus 2 bonds, that would be 0. So this has 0 formal charge. What about the N? The N over here has 1, 2, you have FCN. Valence electrons for N is 5. You have minus no lone pairs, and then you have 1, 2, 3, 4. So it has 4 bonds, and that would be plus 1. So this means this is plus 1. Now, the charges cancel each other and you're left with 0, which fits into this molecule that we have over here. So this is how you would represent the formal charge of nitromethane.